In this module, we will be looking at waves. But the only ones of interest to us are electromagnetic waves traveling at the speed of light, c. For these, the equation c equals lambda nu establishes that the wavelength, lambda, and the frequency, nu, are inversely proportional. In the 1900s, physicists were aware of a few phenomena that classical physics simply could not explain. To treat these, scientists introduced fixes that went against classical physics, but managed to explain the otherwise unexplainable. Planck hypothesized that energy comes in discrete bundles called quanta, whose individual energies, E, are directly related to frequency by E equals nh nu, where h is Planck's constant and n is a positive whole number. Soon after, Einstein proposed that light not only behaved as a wave, it also behaved as a particle. These particles of light, or photons, had an energy h nu, where h is again Planck's constant. Finally, Bohr explained the spectrum of the hydrogen atom by proposing that electrons can occupy only specific orbits defined, like Planck, by positive whole numbers. A fundamentally new approach to physics, called quantum physics, came with the subsequent contributions of de Broglie, Heisenberg, and Schrödinger. It is necessary to explain the physics of very small systems. Chemistry deals with atoms and molecules, and their incredibly small size thus insists upon the use of quantum physics. Inspired by Einstein's wave-particle duality of light, de Broglie proposed a wave-particle duality of matter. Matter's wave nature was a radical proposal, and a seemingly needless one, as nobody had ever really noted it in that way. However, he proposed that a particle had a wavelength, lambda, given by h over mv, where h is yet again Planck's constant, and m and v are the mass and velocity of the particle. For macroscopic objects, its wavelength is simply too small to be observed. However, for an electron, its wavelength is small but larger than the size of the atom it occupies. In other words, if we ignore the wave-particle duality of the electron, we cannot accurately describe the behavior of the atoms and molecules. Building upon matter's wave-particle duality, Heisenberg proposed the uncertainty principle, stating that it is impossible to know with infinite precision both the position and momentum of a particle. Note that it is not a comment on the precision of our instruments. It is a fundamental law of nature. For macroscopic particles, the uncertainties involved are incredibly small. However, like de Broglie, when applied to very small systems, they cannot be ignored. Our physical description of atoms and molecules would be totally incorrect, as the uncertainties in the electron's position are actually larger than the dimensions of these atoms and molecules. It would be like saying that the inhabitant of a house is positioned somewhere in or close to the house he is currently occupying. A rather pointless statement. To handle small systems, Schrödinger gave us his equation h psi equals e psi, where h is the Hamiltonian operator, e is the numerical value of the system's energy, and psi is the wave function. The Hamiltonian operator is a representation of all the energy terms, both kinetic and potential, that respects Heisenberg's principle that position and momentum, and thus potential energy and kinetic energy, cannot be both known with infinite precision. Its precise nature is beyond the scope of this course. The wave function squared tells us everything we can know about the position of the electrons, and this limits us to probabilities. Heisenberg precludes certainty. We can only talk in terms of probability.